A mystery phone call to Lebanon the night before a Sydney toddler disappeared may help solve her abduction case. It will be one of several theories examined at an inquest into Rahma el Dennaoui's disappearance in 2005.
More than 6 years after their daughter disappeared, Hossein and Aliyah el Dennaoui came to the coroner's court in the hope the mystery of what happened to 20-month-old Rahma would be solved. Homicide detectives have no idea whether the girl is still alive. The coroner was told Rahma was with her parents in the lounge room until 2 a.m. before she was taken to a bedroom where four sisters were sleeping and put to bed beneath a window, left open because it was a hot night. Police staged a reenactment showing the fly screen to the bedroom cut from the outside and the toddler snatched from her bed. She was noticed missing at 8 o'clock the next morning. There was a frantic search and police were called in. Counsel assisting the coroner, Robert Bromwich, said an objective inference available is that Rahma has met with foul play of some kind or has been involved in some kind of accident and is no longer alive. The inquiry will hear evidence not previously made public about a phone call between Sydney and Lebanon the day before Rahma disappeared that may have predicted her abduction. One theory is that the girl was taken to Lebanon and is living as the daughter of another couple. Coroner Sharon Froond said in this day and age, toddlers should not go missing from their homes in suburban Australia and never be seen or heard from again. When Rahma disappeared, the El Dennaouis had 8 children. Now they have 11. John Hill, 10 News.